Caston High School timeout for the starting lineup for the Caston Comets. They are 2-0 the season. At one guard will be a 5'6 senior, Marley Lesenby. At a second guard will be a 5'9 senior, Tyranny Rensler. At the third guard will be a 5'9 junior, Sarah Holt. At one forward, 5'8 forward, and 5'8 senior, that is, Michaela Rand. And at the other forward will be a 5'10 senior, Anna Brown. Cast and coach by Mr. Carl Davis. For the Rochester Lady Zebras, they also are 2-0 in the season. At one guard will be a 5'3 sophomore, Alexa Holland. The second guard will be a 5'4 junior, Becky Malco. At one forward, 5'5 sophomore, Keaton Stasiak. The other forward, 5'7 senior, Carly Murphy. And in the middle tonight, for the Rochester Lady Zebras will be 5'10 senior, Bea Pollock. Rochester is led by 14-year head coach, Tony Stasiak. It's electric in here. There's not a lot of fans. Well, the bleachers are on our side are full. There's some across the way. The band is here. The student section is fantastic. But let's talk a little bit, Brad, about this gym. You were in this gym many, many years ago. It looks fantastic.
Yeah, it does. Back to the red border all the way around, the red lines on the floor, the blue-colored lane, and the Caston Comets graphics in the center of the floor. It really looks sharp. They painted the walls. They put in new modern bleachers, and it looks good.
And I think these bleachers will probably accommodate four people come sectional time.
Yeah, and I think I heard that Caston landed sectional for the boys. First time ever they'll host one.
The JV contest tonight went to Caston over Rochester 27-10, the JV 0-3. Everybody that basically was on the floor for Rochester scored: Kendall Davis, Madison Hyatt, Alexa Garrison, Allie Holloway, and Saray Carpenter, each with two for the Rochester Lady Zebras. And Emily Rowe paid the Lady Comets with 10 points. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman, ready for the third game of the regular season. The Rochester Lady Zebras and the Road Blacks. Black shorts, black jerseys with white panels, gold numbers, and letters. The Caston Comets in their home white. White shorts, white jerseys, red and blue panels, and blue and red numbers for the Caston Lady Comets.
Both teams looking to see the first one to go 3-0 in more than a decade.
Pollock and Rensler to jump center. Rochester will go left to right. Caston will go right to left. Ball is up, and the tip controlled by Murphy in the backcourt. So Caston will start with the man-to-man defense. Murphy high on the right side, lob pass down low, tipped away. Matt scrambled for it. Rochester comes out of there with it, and then loses it. Actually, you're going to say Caston loses it out of bounds. It'll stay with Well, he called black.
Yeah.
It'll be white. It was out on
point the wrong direction. Yeah.
So Caston has the basketball after the first turnover of the night against the Rochester Lady Zebras. Lesenby works the point. Rochester will start like we've seen the last two games, Brad, in that 1-3-1 zone defense. Tierney overhead, gives him the corner to Holt. Holder cross court to Lesenby. Out top to Rensler. Between the rings, one dribble, works right side in the corner to Rand.
Brown working awful hard in the paint, and they look for her every time they pass the ball.
Well, she's going to be loading there for B and company, isn't she?
Yeah.
In the corner to Holt, and she loses it out of bounds. A tough pass to handle from Lesenby. And Rochester going to get it back. Both teams with one turnover here early in the game. 45 seconds gone. No score here at Caston High School.
Carly Murphy doing a good job of fronting Brown so that Pollock doesn't have to handle her by herself.
Malco against the defense. Out to Murph. Fakes the three. Drives the baseline. Throws up a shot. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Murph has done a great job at that the last couple of games for Rochester. Faking that shot and driving and kind of leaning in and drawing a lot of contact while shooting.
A foul on Sarah Holt, her first, team first.
7-8 to play in the game. Carly Murphy at the line to shoot two for her. Lady Zebras first on the way is off the back of the iron. No good. One thing that Coach Stasiak prides himself on is getting to the line. However, they're only about 50% good.
Yeah, they haven't had a very good start of the season from the free throw line.
Murph sets herself, fires the second one good this time. Rochester strikes first, 1-0. And Marley Lesenby runs up the right side of the floor across the timeline right, picked up by the 1-3-1 zone defense. To Rensler, one dribble to her right, now swings right to Lesenby. Lesenby high on the left side, now gives her Rensler in the middle of the floor, now left side to Brown. Brown at the elbow, gives him the corner to Holt. Holt, long three from the baseline, draws nothing but air. Malco picks up the board and runs for Rochester. Falco, right side of the floor against Rensler. Hesitates, picks up a dribble now in the paint. Ball stolen away and taken by Brown. And they got Rand, and that gives to Lesnaby, who runs down the left. High on the right side is Rensler, back to Lesnaby in the left wing. Behind the arc against the 1-3-1 zone to the Rochester Lady Zebras. Now left side to Rand. Rand back out. I'm sorry, Brown that it was, back to Rensler. Rensler behind the arc, gives the corner to Holt. Holt looking down low to Brown, but gives right wing to Lesnaby. She'll fire a long three. It's off the mark, no good. And the rebound fought for, and Rochester and Caston, Stasiak and Holt ties up the basketball. It'll be out of bounds to Caston, baseline left. Rochester kind of acted like maybe that rebound snuck up on him. I don't think I saw one black jersey in the air.
Come down off the rim.
Brown. That gives the corner to Lesnaby. Lesnaby looks at the three. Nice recovery by Keaton Stasiak after a hard pick. Out of Rensler. And Rensler is actually going to have a foul away from the basketball. We're going to have a forearm thrown by, I believe, Brown.
Yeah.
But I think she got away with the first foul, the hip check on Stasiak, but not the second elbow. 1-0 Rochester. 2 minutes gone here in the first quarter here at Caston. Falco runs the point, bounce pass to Stasiak at the elbow. Stasiak in the paint, leaner on the way out the window. Too hard, no good. And the rebound to Brown. Makes that to Rand. Rand's down to Rensler, and Caston runs. Down left corner to Hott. Makes that to Holt, a bigger pardon. She'll fire a three in the left wing. Nope. And the rebound again to Falco. That drew nothing but air again. Falco runs right side. Falco misses Stasiak, and the ball is taken away. And when Rand took it away, she traveled. Falco missed Stasiak for about 2 seconds.
Caston's done a good job of getting back and filling them lanes. Rochester's, they think that somebody's opening, and Caston steps in the lane after the ball's been passed.
Holland gets it into Murphy behind the arc on the right wing. Murphy, a couple of dribbles, works against Holt. Leaner on the baseline is short, and the rebound to Holt. Sarah Holt now gives off to Lesnaby. She just about has it stolen. She brings it through the center circle to going to our left. Inside the three-point line, now to Rensler, back to Lesnaby. 1-3-1 zone. It almost looks like a 1-1-3 zone.
All right, it does.
Lesnaby, left wing, wide open three. Off the mark, nope. And the rebound to Falco. That's her third of the night. Becky runs to our right. Falco, right side of the floor, cross lane pass to Stasiak. And before the pass, we're going to have a foul on Caston. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester, baseline right.
That's on Sarah Holt. That's her second, team third.
And Coach Davis will go to the bench quickly and bring in Addie Sarver, a 5'6 sophomore. I beg your pardon, that's going to be J.C. Denton, a 5'6 sophomore. And sitting down will be Holt. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Early in the game here at Caston High School, Rochester leading 1-0. Falco stops, pops, has her shot blocked, ball skipped around, and out of bounds. He's going to say last touch by Caston. He pointed both ways. It will be a last touch by Caston. It will be Rochester basketball, baseline left. Hex, get it in. Lobs in and over the defense. B. Pollock grabs it now, hands off to Murphy between the rings. Under five to play, first quarter, 1-0 Rochester. Murph, three, good. 4-0 Rochester, 4:45 to play in the first quarter.
Carly Murphy with all 4 points for Rochester. She has a knack for finding that three-point shot just when you need it the most.
And that one was a quick catch and shoot.
Yeah.
4-0 Rochester. Tierney, Rensler gets the pass from Lesnaby. Now between the rings, top of the key, back to Lesnaby. Looks at the three, passes it up. She gives it off to Denton for three, in and out, no good. And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Rensler, and it'll go back to the Rochester Lady Zebras, who lead by four with 4:21 to play in the first quarter. Becky Falco runs the point for the Lady Zebras. She'll walk it up the floor. Rensler awaits her at the volleyball line. Falco across the timeline, night. Now drives right, picks up her basketball. Lob pass down low to Pollock. Her jumper off the glass is good. Nice feed by Falco. Nice finish by Pollock. Rochester up 6-0. 4 minutes to play, first quarter. Lesnaby looks back to Coach Davis, has the play. Now will set up the offense, gives him Rensler outside left. Now swings left side to Denton. Denton in the corner to Brown. Back to Rensler in the left wing. Now back to Denton. Looks at a three, now cross court right to Lesnaby. Looks at a three behind the arc right side. Passes up, gives her Rensler at the elbow. Her jumper's short, and a rebound to Holland. Heck, left side, hesitates. Now passes off to Falco, splits a double team in the lane. Outside to X. X now drives to her right. She's in the paint. Gives to Murphy, three on the way. Right side's off the mark, no good. Rebound tipped around, And Rams comes out of the whiff it for the Lady Comets.
I thought Malco had a shot there just inside the elbow in the paint, but she chose not to take it.
Yeah, she was already leaning towards the basket.
Yeah,
she should
exactly.
have just put it up.
But the momentum keep right on taking you there.
6-0 Rochester. 3:10 to play first quarter. Caston to the basketball going to our left. Leslie holds down the corner to Denton. She'll fire a three. It's good. J.C. Denton puts the cast of Comets on the board and cuts his lead in half with under 3 minutes of play in the first quarter. Murph shouts out signals against the man-to-man defense. Top of the key. Around the defense. Lock pass down low. Fortunately for Rochester, tipped out of bounds by Brown. It'll stay with Lady Beavers.
Well, Lady Z's hard habits are hard to break because they're still trying to get it down low to Pollock. Unfortunately for B, Brown is doing a heck of a job of keeping her box away.
You're right. Malco around Rensler in the lane. Right-hand look, hook shot off the glass. No good. And Rensler with the rebound. Tierney runs to our left with the basketball. 2.5 to play first quarter. Rochester up 6-3. In the corner to Denton. Denton in the lane to Brown. Jumper from the paint is good as it bounces off high off the back of the iron and goes through. And right now, Caston on a 5-0 lead. Or 5-0 run, I should say. 6-5 Rochester, 2:15 to play, first quarter. Murphy against Denton, behind her back, dribble in the paint, takes her man to the glass, throws it off there, high off the window, in and out, no good, and the rebound to Brown, and Caston runs to our left, looking to take the lead for the first time tonight, with 2:05 to play in the first quarter. Rensler, middle of the floor, now the wing, drives at the elbow, gives to Brown, jumper from the elbow, short, rebound by Rand, the putback is good, and Caston up 7-6. 1:50 to play in the first quarter. Caston extremely active, both offensively and defensively on the glass.
Yeah, they are. Rand in perfect position for that shot.
Murph, lob pass to Pollock. B takes it back out to Murph in the right corner. Down the baseline, pull up 5-footer short. Pollock with the rebound. She puts it back up on the window. It's no good. Ball being tipped around, and we're going to have a foul over the back, I believe, on Caston. Daziak was trying to look for position. I believe Caston came over the back.
That's going to be on Rams, her first team fourth.
90 seconds to play, first quarter. Caston up 7-6. Rochester basketball to bounce baseline left. Bounce pass comes into Murphy in the left corner. Murphy, a couple of dribbles, gives back to Holland. Holland, step back behind the three, now drives the free throw line. Still keeps her dribble. Now left side to Murph. Murph, stop, pop, foul of the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's the kind of thing Charlie Murphy needs to continue to keep doing. Push that ball in and force the Caston Lady Comet defense to come
Denton?
Out play deep.
Yeah, so,
two on range.
No, I'm sorry. No. That was on Lesnby. I beg your pardon.
Oh, okay.
Murphy at the line to shoot two. First one of the way for the seniors. In and out. No good. She'll have one more. Rochester now 1-for-3 as a team. And trail to Caston Comet 7-6 with 1:19 to play in the first quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Second by Murph. Looks better this time. It is good. We're tied at 7. Caston with the basketball. Farley Lesenby, a 5'6 senior, will walk it up the floor. Third baseman for the Caston softball team. Left side to Denton. High on the left side. Now back to Lesenby near the timeline. Around the defense, gives to Rensler. Couple of dribbles against the double team. In the paint to Brown. Back outside to Denton. Now to Lesenby. Lesby against the almost like a trapping defense, doesn't
it? Yeah, it's like they're trying to trap the ball on the corners.
Brown, 10-footer, no good. And the rebound is going to be knocked out of bounds by Rochester with 49.3 to play. In the first quarter, we're tied at 7.
And again, Rand's right there on the opposite side looking for the loose ball.
Here's where my concern is. Anna Brown has won a couple of buckets, or maybe just one bucket, but her looks are fantastic in the paint.
She's getting a lot of good looks just inside the elbow.
Lesnamy to Rensler from the elbow. Jumper's good. Tierney Rensler has her first bucket of the game to put the Comets back up 9-7 with 35 seconds to play in the first quarter, and Coach Daziak wants the final shot. Malco, crossover dribble in the paint. Stops down low to Daziak. Wide open shot is good off the glass. And we're tied at 9 with 25 seconds to play first quarter. Rensler right through the center circle with 20. Tierney Rensler works to her left, now back to her right, gives to Lesnaby with 14, back to Rensler with 12. Between the rings is Tierney Rensler, now to Lesnaby with 7. Lesnaby back to Rensler with 6.
Looking Rensler for Denton maybe on the wing.
Brown now with 2. Now Denton with 1. 3 at the buzzer. Good! Caston is the one, leads 12-9. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
You make a sound investment when you choose a New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractor from New Holland Rochester. You get big engine and hydraulic power and up to 10% cost savings thanks to cutting-edge Echo Blue SCR engine technology. It saves you money on fuel, and ground speed management adjusts both engine and transmission speeds for better field performance and economy. Stop by New Holland Rochester and see what New Holland T9 Series four-wheel drive tractors can do for your operation. New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
And we're all about pets.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets, downtown Rochester, is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet health care supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all about pets.
Zebra Basketball, WROI. Going to the second quarter here at Caston High School, the Lady Comets leading 12-9 after a long three-point bomb by Denton as the quarter ended.
Stacey Denton with two threes in that quarter coming off the bench, including that, 23-footer at the end of the quarter.
That was a long shot. You know, Caston withstood the first series of punches by the Rochester Lady Sabres and came back and fought back from the 6-0 deficit, took a three-point lead. Here as we start the second quarter here at Caston, and Rochester will have the basketball going to our right.
Hannah Brown doing a great job defensively on B. Pollock, too, down low.
Step back jumper in the lane for Falco is no good. And Caston with the rebound. You know, Coach Stasiak has not ever lost to the Caston Lady Comets. 13 years in a row, Rochester's won, and it might be more than that. I'll tell you why it's only 13. Lesenby, a long three. Nope. All off the back of the iron. Denton with the rebound, gives it back to Lesenby. So that's the only... You only go back 14 years on the IHSA website.
Yeah, there you go.
Lesenby, 1-3-1 zone by Rochester. The Rensselaer baseball pass to Denton. Back to Lesenby, just inside the arc. Long jumper is no good, and Pollock with the board. B now gives off to Malco, crosses the center circle, works to the right side, crossover dribble to paint, leaner on the way, it's good. Has a big bucket there by Rochester, who ended about a three-minute scoring drought. To pull the Zebras within one with 7 minutes to play first half. Rensselaer at the elbow to Brown. Out to Lesenby, now to Rensselaer at the elbow right. Long jumper is off the mark, no good. Murphy grabs the board. And now run. Murphy works to her left. Now drives the left side. Her leaner on the way is no good. B. Brown fought for, and Brown comes out of there with it. A lot of contact there, and Murphy was hoping for a foul. Nothing doing. And Caston grabs the board and comes the other way. With a one-point lead, 12-11, Caston. Rensselaer, high left side is Lesenby with 6.5 to play in the first half. Rensselaer in the corner to Rand. Back to Rensselaer on the right wing, now to Lesenby behind the arc. Works against X. Now inside the arc, kicks it out to Rensselaer. Rensselaer drives to her left. On the baseline, passes too high for Brown to handle, and it goes out of bounds. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We're at Caston High School. And the Caston Lady Comets lead the Rochester Lady Zebras 12-11. 6 minutes to play in the first half. Malco from the free throw line. High off the back of the rim, no good. B. Pollock, her putback is good. She gets a rebound and a putback, and Rochester up now 13-12.
And I think Coach Stasiak recognized that there's a lot of open shots just in there around the free throw line.
And now Carly Murphy is going to be whistled on the reach in, which will be Rochester's first foul of the half, or 5:50 to play in the second quarter. Not bad. Boy, they have done a really good job in the first, well, almost 2.5 games of fouling.
You're right.
Or the lack thereof. 5:50 to play, first half.
Yep. I'll pick up a foul.
And Keaton Stasiak picks up a foul, and Coach Stasiak thinks that referee maybe had it out for a little bit. So, Rochester's second team foul with 5:48 to play in the first half. Rensselaer's just inside the arc. Her jumper off the glass, no good. Stasiak with the board, gives to Malco. 13-12 Rochester. Malco through the center circle. Works against Rensselaer. Bounce pass to X. Quick three, left wing. Nope. Gets her own rebound at the free throw line. Bounce pass to Malco. Becky off the armpit of Rentler, wrap around past Stasiak, and we're going to have a, the ball goes out of bounds. We're going to say last touch by Brown after Stasiak gives Brown a little hip check. No foul, but Rochester will keep possession baseline left. 5:24 to play, first half. Rochester by one. Murphy will look to inbound for Rochester. Murphy studies. Bounce pass to X on the right baseline. X around the defense. Floater in the lane. Off the glass and good. Rochester back up by three. It's 15-12. Lesnaby runs for Caston. Right side of the floor. Now to Rentler high on the left side. Bounce pass down low to Brown. She'll take the 10-footer. No good. And Malcolm with a great block out and grabs the board. Now Murphy and Rochester runs to our right up by three. Murphy at the free throw line hesitates and then bounces the basketball off her knee and out of bounds. Nice job by Brown, I think. He got a finger in there and kind of disrupted the dribble and went out of bounds.
Right. Well, I was going to say, good job by Murphy, too, to just recognize that nobody's going to pick her up square. Just take that ball right down the lane and get the layup again.
Here comes the Rochester half-court grab or run and jump defense, as some coaches call it. Rentler around the defense to Brown. Brown against the triple team, throws it away in the hands of X. Holland then loses the handle. Stasiak picks it up. She loses it. And now we're going to have a foul. Oh, wow. And Rentler, wow. Wow, 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 wow. That's a tough foul to take if you're Kearney Rentler and Coach Carl Davis. Both girls are trying for the ball. They kind of got tangled up. I didn't see anything wrong with it. And Kearney Rentler is going to be whistled for the foul.
I think as Rentler was going down, she put her hand out to try and catch herself. At the same time, Stasiak's falling backwards. And it, I think from his vantage point, it might have looked like he pulled Stasiak back.
Yeah, I
think both of them just lost their balance.
So Rochester will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
WROI. 4:41 to play in the first half. Rochester up 15-12, and after the Rochester timeout, Lady Zebra will have it right in front of the cast event.
Got to get it in.
Stasiak's got to get it in, and just does at the 4.5 count to Holland. X runs the point, top of the key against the man-to-man defense. Murphy wide open left wing. Gives to Malco. Becky Malco then travels before her first dribble, and she would have had an easy wide open 5-footer.
Right, yep.
They're having a tough time. Caston is picking up that defense and keeping Rochester out of the paint. 15-12. Rochester, 4:25 to play in the first half.
Say their defensive focus is obviously on Pollock.
Yeah.
Low.
Holt back in the basketball game. Picks up her dribble outside to Rentler. Between the rings, top of the key. Rentler, one dribble to her left. Back to Holt on the right wing. Lesnaby runs the baseline, and the pass to Rand goes out of bounds. That's a tough pass to handle on her ankle. And it goes back to Rochester.
For the Lady Z's, both Pollock and Murphy work in the middle of the paint, putting a double team on whatever side the ball drops down to, either Rands or Brown.
15-12 Rochester, 4 minutes to play, first half. Malco high on the right side, lob pass into double coverage. Goes out of bounds, they're going to say last touch by Pollock.
Wow.
It'll go back to Caston.
Lazenby dropped in behind Pollock, and Brown was fronting her. An ill-advised pass down to Pollock, I would say.
So after another Rochester turnover, the Caston Lady Comets will have it going to our left, down by three. Rentler high on the left side, gives the hold to the right elbow. Hold back to Rentler. Grabs a tough pass. That works to the right wing. To Brown. 10-footer in the paint is good. She has had that look all night.
Yeah, you get the feeling that she's comfortable putting that jump shot up anywhere from the free throw line down.
Rochester's lead is one. Murphy in the paint. Spinner on the way high off the glass is good. And it's 17-14, Rochester, 3:20 to play in the first half. Rentler runs the point for Caston, right wing behind the arc. Gives to Holt. She also two behind the arc. Looks for Lesnaby in the left wing. But it gives to Rentler on the right side. At the free throw line to Brown, out to Holt. Drives around the defense. Loses the handle. Picked up by Malco. Got an X. Back to Malco.
Travel.
Yes, she did. Center circle. Now left elbow out to Murphy. Rochester by three with 2:55 to play in the first half. Murphy in the paint. Gives down low to Stasiak. Her jumper off the window is good.
Well, Lady Comet defense, they have to respect Murphy. She's got 7 of the 19 points. When they came up to stop her, Stasiak is
wide open. You're right. 5-point lead now for Rochester, 19-14. Turnaround jumper for Brown is good. And P. Pollock turned around and said, that's my bad. I lost track of her, and Brown got an easy bucket. And now the Lady Zebras lead is just 3 with 2:25 to play in the first half. 19-16 Rochester. Murphy, wide open 3, in and out, no good. And the rebound to Lesenby. I mean, wide open, Brad.
Yeah, good five look feet. For Murph.
Yeah.
She has to take that. They're not going to guard her.
Nobody within 5 feet of her. She has to, you're right, has to take that. Corner to Lesenby. Looking for Brown being double team on the block. Out of Rensler. Down a hole with 2 minutes to play in the third.
I guarantee if she made it, they wouldn't forget her the next time.
Yeah, you're right. Rensler, under 2 to play in the first half. Rochester by 3. Now a hold left wing. Rands at the free throw line. To Rensler, down low to Brown. Jumper over. Murphy's good. Nice ball move by Lady Comet. And they're within 1 of the lead.
Brown now with 8 points.
A minute 40 to play first half. Falco against Rensler. Picks up her dribble. Now to Holland. Murphy has it now. Murphy travels. Boy, Rochester's playing barnyard blacktop basketball right now, and it's just not going real well. Very little offense, in my opinion,
right.
Is being ran.
You're right, and I think you got to contribute that to the defense of Lady Comets. They're really, their face guarding the guards up front, with a few exceptions on Murphy. It's got free down low in the paint, but, you know, they pretty well shut Pollock down low.
Yeah. 5'9 freshman Alexa Garrison in the game for the first time tonight. And Murphy will sit. 1:15 to play, first half. Rochester up 19-18. And Caston with the basketball. Rands high on the right side, and Coach Davis running some clock here. We've seen his offense before. Now Brown, a bounce pass to Rensler. 66 seconds to play, first half. Rochester by 1, and Lesby now runs against the 2-3 zone. Rand, back door to Holt. Her jumper is short. Rebound by Rand. The putback is no good. Pollock with a board. Rochester outruns with 50 seconds to play in the first half. And Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's slow up. We're up by 1 with 45 seconds to play in the first half. Looking for the final shot, if possible. Man-to-man defense by Caston. Falco works against Rensler. Behind her back dribble in the paint. Down low to Pollock. Pollock, jumper off the window. Nope. Rebound fought for, and Brown comes out of the whip it. Now gives Lesenby with 28.
And the ladies, these are not going to get more than one opportunity to get that shot at the hole.
And now Coach Davis wants a 30-second timeout. 23 seconds to play first half. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirements. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
23.3 seconds to play in the first half. Rochester leading 19-18. Caston will have the basketball right in front of the Rochester bench. And probably Brad, Coach Davis is saying, hey, I want one shot. Let's go to the locker room, either down by 1 or up by 1 or 2.
Well, Dent's not in the game right now for the Lady Comets. She had the 2 big threes in the first quarter. So we'll have to look for somebody new. Brown's been the hot hand in this quarter for the Lady Comets. But I would not be surprised to see Lesenby take a shot.
Lesenby against Garrison. Rochester, the man-to-man defense. Well, maybe a 2-3 zone. Now Eck and Brown tied up. And it'll go. It'll stay with Caston. 14.4 to play in the first half. Rochester up by 1. Caston has the basketball. Lesenby works against Garrison. Garrison, Lesenby with 5. After Rensler with 4. Down low to Brown with 2. Rebound by Garrison. Baseball pass with X. Half quarter is not going to count.
And she did not get a shot off. So at halftime, Lady Zebras leading 19-18. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball on 92.1 WROI.
Latex paint with stain resistance and great coverage. And get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects, plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store. Monday through Friday, 7 to 7. Saturday, 7 to 6. Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Caston High School. We're going to the third quarter with Rochester up 19-18, Brett.
For the Lady Comets, Tierney Ritzler with two, Michaela Rands with two, Anna Brown with eight, and J.C. Denton with six. For the Lady Zebras, Alexa Holland with two, Keaton Stasiak with four, Becky Malko with two, B. Pollock with four, and Carly Murphy with seven.
Foul situations for Rochester?
Stasiak and Murphy each with one.
Good.
And for the Lady Comets, Sarah Holt has two. Nobody really in any foul trouble.
Rochester starts the second half with the basketball. Murphy splits the seam down to Pollock. Jumper off the glass is good over Brown. And Rochester back up by three at 21-18. Lesenby works right side. I'm telling you, that looks like a 1-1-3 zone. And I'm going to have to ask Coach Stasiak about that in the postgame.
Well, I'm guessing he got Murphy slide down off the shoulder to help Pollock down low with Brown and Rams.
Rinsler, kind of against X, out to Holt. Cross court right to Lesenby for three, right wing, short, and rebound to Holland. Tierney Rinsler very lucky she didn't get an over the back call. Holland, top of the key, hesitates, now penetrates, and her pass is taken away by Rams. And Caston runs to our right, down by three at 21-18, a minute gone to the third quarter. That's behind the left side to Rinsler. Rinsler in the right baseline to Rand. Now to Brown, 10-footer, good. Their ball movement is very good tonight.
It is, and Brown is on fire. She's got her range from about 8 to 10 feet.
I was going to say, and that ball movement, it results in a wide-open Brown who makes it look easy from 10 feet. 21-20 Rochester. Malko, leaner in the paint, off the back of the rim, no good. Rands with the rebound. And Rand gives off to Lesenby. Caston with an opportunity to take lead here. Going to our right. Rinsler high on the left side, now gives to Holt. Rochester in a zone defense. To Lesenby, right wing.
Brown working the free throw line. Brands on the baseline.
Holt, bounce pass to Brown. Brown against Murphy, outside to Rinsler. Now the pass was out of bounds, a tough pass to handle, and Lesenby couldn't catch up with it. It goes out of bounds, and back into the game comes Denton for Caston. You know, Rochester's played six, Caston's only played six.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yep. Denton with two big three-pointers in the first quarter for the Lady Comets.
21-20 Rochester, 6 minutes to play, third quarter. At the elbow, Stasiak. Stasiak in the paint, goes to the basket. Harder layup is good. Caton with two more and puts the Zebras back up by three. Rinsler high on the left side to Lesenby. Lesenby behind the arc. They'll look past to Rinsler at the elbow. Not even looking for that shot. Gets to Rand. Back to Lesenby in the right wing. And Murphy and B. Pollock fronting and playing behind Brown. Pass almost taken away. Lesenby has it. Cross court pass to Rinsler. Her jumper from 10 feet is good.
They just keep moving that ball and reversing the floor and moving in a little closer each time.
23-22. Rochester the basketball. Stasiak wraparound pass to Pollock. Loses it out of her hands out of bounds. Good look by King Stasiak, and B couldn't handle the pass. 5:16 to play. Third quarter, 23-22. Rochester and the Lady Comets of Caston with the basketball going to our right.
Something the Lady Zebras aren't doing now is getting to the free throw line.
Yep. But with that being said, neither is Caston.
You're right.
Lesenby to Rands on the right block against the double team. Rands left wing to Lesenby. Her three is in and out, no good. Ball tipped around, and Paula comes out of there with it, gives to Murphy. Murph runs for Rochester to our left. 4:45 to play, third quarter, Rochester by one. Murphy works to the right wing, picks up her dribble. They get rid of it. Bounce pass to Malko. Malko, a couple of dribbles out to Murph, and they'll reset near the timeline. Brad Thomas on David Musselman. Murphy in the paint, leaner on the way, high off the glass, too hard. Ball loose, picked up by Stasiak.
15, bounce pass to Malco, runs the baseline, wrap around pass to Stasiak, who loses the basketball, and it's going to be out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester, as Malco did not come in and snap a 2 feet inbounds before she grabbed the basketball.
And one thing that the Lady Comets are doing that the Lady Zebras are having a hard time with, and there's being very physical down in the paint. You're not going to get a shot off without somebody giving you a little hip check.
Yep. They're letting them play, that's for sure.
Yep.
They being obviously the officials. Brinsel on the wing behind the arc. 4 minutes to play, third quarter. Bounce pass to Lesby. Now in the corner to Denton. Her three is in and out. No good.
Almost.
And Malco with the rebound. Malco runs around the defense. Right-handed layup. And we're going to have a foul on Rensler. Boy, I didn't think that was going to be called. It happened right here in front of this cat that we're looking at. He did not call it. The trail official did. And that's going to send Malco to the line to shoot two.
That'll be her second foul, team first.
Been a long time since Rochester shot free throws, and I believe the only one has done so is Murphy.
Right.
So Becky Malco, the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras, who are up by one. First for the sophomore, rolls around and falls through. Rochester up by two with 3:54 to play. In the third quarter, Brad Thomas on David Musselman. Becky Malco will have one more for the Lady Zebras. Fires a second one, no good. And Brown with the rebound. Gives to Rensler. Caston runs down by two. Here comes a half-court trap. Rensler almost throws it away. Gets it to Denton. She'll fire another three. No good. Malco with the board. And then dribbles it off her foot. Out of bounds. No signal yet. Actually, they're going to say last touch by Rensler. It'll stay with Rochester. 3:40 to play in the third. Rochester by two. They've got the basketball going to our left. Next. It's a man-to-man defense. Right wing. Hesitate. Now works for left side. Bounce pass to Murphy. High on the left side for Rochester. Get where she gets Rand.
Very tough man-to-man defense.
Murphy goes all the way to the basket hard. The shot falls off the rim. No good. And the rebound to Rand.
Ladies, these are getting close, but they're just not getting them the ball.
Well, I was just going to say, from 5 foot in, they've had a lot of looks. He just can't get anything to go.
You're right.
Rensler kicks it out to Lesenby. Looks at the three and passes it up. Back to Rensler. Left wing. Rensler, a couple of drives, left side, now in the paint to Rand. She's fouled the shot. Her puck is good and a foul. Becky Malco picked up her first foul. And with that shot made, we're tied at 24 and going to the free throw line is Michaela Rand looking for the lead.
Rand did a good job of getting herself inside of Malco, and on the missed shot, she was there for the rebound and the putback, and Malco stuck behind her.
Michaela Rand's in line with 3:01 to play in the third. Free throw is good and cast it up. 25-24. Biggest lead for either team is six, and that was Rochester. That didn't last long, though. And Caston's led. I think her biggest lead has been one or two here in this basketball game. Be at the free throw line. Out to Malco at the volleyball line. Malco holds, now drives around Rensler, off her foot, out of bounds. No, they're going to say last touch by Caston again.
In the pregame interview, Coach Davis said that he thought B. Pollock really hurt him last year. And, boy, Anna Brown and Michaela Rands have really done a good job keeping ball B away from the basket.
I agree. Murphy in the paint, loses the handle, picks it up, out to X, right side to Malco. Becky drives, stops, pops, good as it rattles home. Rochester back up 26-25, and boy, it is getting physical down low between Brown and Pollock. Rensler back to Lesby on the right wing, back to Rensler behind the arc. Tierney drives, and she's going to be fouled on the reach-in. Is that going to be on X?
I think so. It is the first.
Garrison back into the game and coming out for Rochester will be Carly Murphy. 2:21 to play, third quarter. Rochester up 26-25. Cast the basketball to bounce baseline left. Lesby looks to get it in. Lesby looking, lobs it in to Rensler. Rensler loses the handle, puts it up anyway. It's good. Cast it back up 27-26. Not sure if she got that one to go as that ball was bounced on the floor. She lost it through her hands, and as it's on the way up, she goes ahead and puts it in anyway. Three by X is no good, and Caston the rebound. Rensler runs for the Lady Comets. Up by one with under 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. Caston the basketball high on the left side is Lesenby. Now to Rensler at the free throw line. Gives to Brown, 10-footer's good. Money all day.
Automatic, she's got 12 now.
And she's had 12 from about that same spot on the floor. 29-26, The floater lane by X is good, and it cuts the lead to one with 95 seconds to play here in the third. Caston up 29-28. Lesby, left side to Rensler. Back to Lesby, right wing. Looks at the three, passes up, gives to Rensler. She got the jump for it over her head. Kind of didn't. 5 feet behind the arc. Lesby, long three, short, and Garrison with the board. Alexa Garrison now gives to Stasiak, who gives to Malco. A minute 10 to play, third in the third. Caston up by one at 29-28. Malco through the center circle. Man-to-man defense for the Lady Comet. Works right side of the elbows. Puts the defense to X. Quick three, right side. No good. And Garrison, the weak side rebound, and she travels.
Those are three-point shots they got to have fall. Lady Zebras want to try and open that paint up for B. Pollock.
Right. 59.6 to play in the third. Caston by one. Doesn't be taking a lot of time as across the timeline.
Last shot for the Lady Comets.
Rensler, couple of dribbles. Gives him the corner to Denton. Down low, Grand. Her pass is tipped away and stolen by Malco. Malco, right-handed layup off the window and good. Rochester back up 30-29 with 30 seconds to play in the third. And Rensler runs. The Rand with 26, back to Rensler with 25, down to Lesby with 23. Lesby holds, then now to Denton with 19. Top of the key to Rensler with 17, and her pass is taken away by B. Pollock. 15 seconds, Malco has it with 13. Cross the timeline with 10. Malco middle floor with 8. Malco right side, crossover dribble to paint. Stop, pop, no good. Rebound, fall for, she has it with 3. Gives to X with 2. Her shot blocked, picked up by Pollock. Put back in the bunker, no good. After 3, Rochester leads 30-29. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. You'll find really huge savings. They offer in-store specials, and they have the equipment, backpacks, and duffels for your favorite sport. They carry major apparel brands, including Under Armour, Russell, Adidas, and so many more. Visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Rao Place Drive, Rochester.
As long as the kids keep making the traveling team and the new restaurant across town doesn't deliver, you're going to be driving. So it's a smart choice to join new BP Driver Rewards. You receive an instant 10 cents per gallon reward just for signing up. With every second fill up of quality BP gasoline, you keep earning and saving 5 cents per gallon. Pick up a BP Driver Rewards brochure at your local BP to join now. Up to 20 gallons, terms and conditions apply. See bpdriverrewards.com for details.
A new dual car wash combining both soft cloth and high pressure technology for a really clean car is coming to the Good to Go Car Wash. Purchase your wash at either Good to Go locations and save up to 20 cents per gallon on your gas purchase. Give it a try beginning November 1st.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth and final quarter we go. The Rochester Lady Zebras leading the Caston Lady Comets here at Caston High School 30-29. And what Rochester's done so well in the first two games, Brad, is get to the free throw line, and really nobody has been here, been there in this game.
Now, it's been a physical ball game, but nobody's getting to the free throw line. Rochester having a hard time handling the physicality and the fact that they're not getting too many good looks.
The ball is taken away by Holland after Malco broke up the pass. And Holland runs to our left, down the paint, kicks it out to Murphy, fakes the three right around the defense in the paint. Leaner on the way, going to foul the shot. Perk will go to the line to shoot two. That was a different look starting the fourth quarter defensively for Rochester.
That foul coming on Lathenby, her first. I'm sorry, her second, team second.
7:34 to play in the game. Rochester up 30-29. And Carly Murphy will go to the line to shoot two shots for her Lady Zebras. Murph ready. Eyes the first one. Flies it. Hit the front of the iron. Bounces up. Hits the backboard and goes in. Rochester has not hit
4-7.
Two consecutive free throws tonight, have they?
Oh.
No, I didn't think so.
4-7 from the line.
One more coming for Murphy, looking to push this lead back to 3. Biggest lead for Caston has been 3. Biggest lead for Rochester, 6. Segment for Murphy is no good. And the rebound to Rand. And Rensler now runs it through the center circle, going to our right. Rochester by 2. Rensler on the left wing. loses the basketball. Ball loose, picked up by Holland. And Holland's going to be fouled on the reach-in. I believe Rand. Nope, I think it's going to be on Brown. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester here in front of the scorer's table.
That is on Brown, her second, team third. And the Lady Comets have committed four consecutive turnovers.
Really?
Four possessions.
I'm watching the same game, didn't realize that. Two-point lead for Rochester with 7:17 to play in the game. X in the paint, stops, kicks it out to Murphy. Murphy holds down a loose ball at the timeline. Now we'll reset the volleyball line. Middle of the floor, works right side. Crossover dribble in the paint. Spin move, jumper off the window. Nope, rebound by Rands and Caston. Got a Rentler. 31-29 Rochester, under 7 minutes to play in the basketball game. Lesenby against the double team, works around the defense, down a little wide over Brown. Her jumper, no good, gets her own rebound. Ball is then stripped from behind by Murphy, and she gets off to Malco. Becky runs, left side of the floor, at the elbow, caught off by the defense, out to Murphy, high on the right side. Murph, stop, pop, nope, and the rebound to Rand. Rochester up 31-29, 6.5 to play in the game. Caston running to our right. Rentler against Peck. No look pass to Rands, and she's going to be fouled on the shot. Good heavens. On the shot, and she'll go to the line to shoot two.
He paused to pick up her first, team third.
So going to the line will be Michaela Rand, the 5'8 senior for Caston, looking to tie this game up at 31.
She's got the only free throw for the Lady Comets tonight, and that's 5 points.
Make it six as that first free throw with no spin goes in. It's a knuckleball. They're all knuckleballs. One more coming for Rands and Caston Lady Comets, looking to tie the score at 31. Sets herself, fires a second one. Nope. Stasiak with the board and gives to Murphy. 31-30 Rochester, 6:15 to play in the game. Falco through the center circle, accelerates right. Lob pass goes out of bounds.
Into the lobby.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to hit the bottom of the backboard. I think B. Pollock maybe thought so too.
That's what I was hoping for, but it didn't work. Because B wasn't going to get that. You couldn't have got that one.
I don't think B even tried. I think she was waiting for it to hit the backboard.
Little half-court trap coming for Rochester's defense. Led to be across the timeline. Lob pass to Brown. Brown against Murphy. Wraparound pass to Rand. Her jumper, no good. And the rebound to Murphy.
Wow. Rands and Brown really working down low. And one or the other is always open.
You're talking about point blank, not going. Rochester by one. 5:44 to play in the game. X against Lesenby. Makes the three. The Murphy makes that to Malco. Drives the baseline. No good. Pollock with the rebound. Her put back over Brown is no good. Malco with the rebound. And we're going to have a foul against Caston Rentler. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline left.
That'll be her third. Team fourth.
5.5 to play in the game. Rochester up 31-30. Holland looks to get it in. Bounce pass into Stasiak through her hand. And it goes out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Stasiak. It'll go back to Caston. I think Stasiak pulled up thinking it was going to be off of Caston. And the referees converge and decide it was off of Keaton. Still 31-30 Rochester. Half-court trap coming for the Lady Zebras. Rentler around the defense, gives to Rand. Rand down low against Stasiak. Backs away in, throws up a shot. It's no good. Stasiak with the board. Point blank again. Keaton gave up some size and some height and is able to grab that rebound. 31-30 Rochester. 5 to play in the game. Malco stands to the volleyball line and just dribbles. Rentler stands back at the free throw or the three-point line and lets her. Clock running. She backs it out near the timeline.
Rentler with three fouls. There's not probably a lot that she could do aggressively.
Malco kicks it out to X. X, leaning off the window, is in the foul.
Rentler going to pick up the fourth. He does indeed.
Rochester's pushed this lead to three, and a free throw coming for sophomore Alexa Holland. More than likely, Coach Davis is going to have to go to the bench, but he does not. He's going to leave her in there. Free throw for X. Good. 34-30, and now Denton will come back into the game for Caston, and Kearney Rentler will sit down. 4:44 to play in the game. Rochester by four. And here comes the half-court trap again, Brad.
It's worked earlier in the game, forced a few turnovers.
Pleasant beat.
This time, though, we've got Rams up in midcourt.
Denton. And then Hughes in trouble. And Coach Davis uses a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Ladies Hear Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
If you want to improve your farming efficiency and profits, rely on New Holland Precision Land Management Solutions from New Holland Rochester. They put the latest technology on your side to save you money for a faster return on your investment. PLM helps you achieve perfectly straight, repeatable passes, eliminating double application of seed and fertilizer, and allows you to analyze your field data. Discover what you can save with PLM Solutions from New Holland. They are experts in the field, so you can get more precision in yours. Stop by New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South, today.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Four and a half minutes to play in the basketball game. Rochester up 34-30. And after the Caston timeout, they'll have the basketball right in front of their own bench. And Pleasantby stands on the Rochester side of the timeline, now crosses the timeline against the double team. Ball's tipped away. Rand has it, though. Rand tries to clear room with her elbow. Does so and gives back to Pleasantby.
Brown working down low against Stasiak. That was the matchup they wanted.
Rand then is fouled. Entry pass by Murphy. And it'll be out of bounds to Caston. Baseline right. 4:18 to play in the game. Rochester up 34-30.
Murphy's second, team fourth.
Murphy's only one with two, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yep. Lesnaby looks to get it in. Lob pass into Holt. Layup is good. That worked to perfection. Somebody lost track of Sarah Holt.
It's her first 2 points of the game.
And that cuts the lead in half. And it's 34-32. Three for X. Off the back of the iron. No good. Rebound. Fall for Stasiak. Has it. The putback. Good and a foul.
Nice job by Keith Stasiak. Always around the basketball. That time she gets the loose ball and gets the foul on the putback.
Well, you know, you talked to Coach Stasiak, and that's kind of like that preview show. And he talked highly about Keaton. I know he doesn't like to because his daughter and, you know, things like that. But she brings her hardware out to work every day, her lunch pail to work every day. And that right there shows you how hard a worker she is, that rebound and putback.
Averaging 8 points a game, and she's got eight right now with an opportunity to go to nine. And that was Anna Brown's third foul for the Lady Commons.
Keaton right at her game average.
Yep. The only one at her game average.
Yeah. Stasiak free throw. No good. And the rebound to Rand. 36-32 Rochester. Four to play in the game. Lesnaby now through the center circle. Works to the right side. Out of Holt. Rand's in the right corner. Back to Holt right wing. Inside the arc now. Going to get rid of it against the double team. And she puts up a shot and it goes. Holy moly. If in doubt, just shoot it. That's kind of what that was. Let's see. Nobody's open. Okay, we'll just shoot it.
They've got the confidence to shoot it. You don't see, they may be trying to get it down low to Brown, but when push comes to shove, they'll shoot.
Malco all the way to the paint, and she misses the layup. And the rebound to Brown. 3:29 to play in the game. Rochester by two is 36-34. Cross-court pass to Lesnaby.
Brown has not scored in this quarter, and the Lady Comets are still within two.
Lesnaby on the right wing. Back to hole between the, actually behind the arc. Dribbles around the defense in the paint. Floater on the way is short. And safe from going out of bounds, the right in the hands of Stasiak. Keaton runs. Keaton right side of the floor. Does not have the numbers. Stop. Toss off the glass. Nope. And the rebound to Rand. 3 minutes to play in the game. Rochester by two. Caston running to our right. Hold high on the left side. Bounce pass to Lesnaby. Takes the three. Now penetrates. She loses the handle. Picked up by Malco. Malco drive. And now we'll pull it back out. We'll run some clock. 2:40 to play in the game. Rochester up 36-34. Malco backs her way to the timeline. Now runs towards the basket. Outside to Stasiak behind the arc. Right corner. Keaton picks up her dribble.
Coach Stasiak trying to get the Lady Zebras to spread the floor. Trying to spread that defense out of the paint.
Murphy near the timeline. Now the clock, count starts for the defense. Murphy, couple of dribbles, gives to Malco with 2:15. Becky in the paint. Down low to Pollock. Bees jumper short. Rebound ball for out of bounds. Going to stay last touch by Caston. And it'll stay with Rochester with 2:11 to play in the game. Rochester up 36-34. And then Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farm Store has everything you need to get ready for fall. Cooler weather is on its way, and they have a great selection of United States stoves in stock, including pellet, multi-fuel, and furnaces. Get those outdoor projects finished with the help of steel during Fall Steel Days. Right now, buy an MS-271 chainsaw and get a free chain, or pick up a VG-56CE chainsaw and get a free safety combination pack. Smith Farm Store, your friendly local hardware store in Rochester and Plymouth.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:11 to play in the game. Rochester leads 36-34. Both teams with three timeouts, and Rochester has the arrow, the possession arrow. Holland lobs it over the defense to Malco near the volleyball line. Rensler back in there with four fouls around the defense. In the paint, she's going to be called for double dribble.
Yep.
And Caston going to get it back, up by two.
Down two.
Caston going to get it back, down by two. With 2:06 to play in the game. Rensler over the defense to Holt, cross court. And the ball tipped away, picked up by Lesenby. Now left side to Holt. Oh, in the lane, has her pass picked off by Pollock. Man. Down to Murphy.
Had Brown wide open on the baseline. They didn't miss. They missed and tried to go cross court. Pollock did a good job of stepping in.
Minute 45 to play in the game. Caston's next foul. Rochester will be in the shooting free throws. Next down the minute 40. Rochester up 36-34. Next couple of dribbles. Now backs away to the timeline. Works to the right side. Now crossover dribble, left elbow. Out to Murphy with a minute 30. Murphy against Rand. Couple of dribbles, backs the way into the free throw line. Cross court to Stasiak in the minute 20. Keaton, one dribble. Between the defense to X, makes a three in the minute 15. She backs it out, runs clock in the minute 12. She works against Rand. This could be a mismatch. X around the defense. Now backs it back outside with 60 seconds to play in the game. Out past the corner to Murphy. Through the paint, bounce pass to Malco with 54. Becky Malco around the defense. Dribbles away from it, gives to Murphy to the free throw line with 48. Murphy. And then we're going to have a foul coming on Lesenby, and that's going to send Carly Murphy to the line for one and the bonus with 45.9 to play in the game.
That's what Coach Stasiak wanted, running about 45, 50 seconds off the clock, just waiting for that foul.
That started that after that timeout. It started what 33?
Something. Yeah.
A minute 35 to play.
Yeah.
And now we're down to 45.9 to play in the game. Murphy has two big ones here. Well, one of the bonus, let's say. First one's no good. Stasiak at the rebound, and she has it tipped out of bounds by Rands. It'll stay with Rochester with 44 seconds.
But that's just what Coach Stasiak wanted. He needed the foul to get into the bonus. He was going to run the clock until Lady Thomas fouled.
Lesenby picked up foul number three. And Coach Davis will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets, downtown Rochester, is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet health care supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all about pets.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
44.2 seconds of play in the game. Madison Taylor, a 5'4 junior, comes into the game for fouling purposes as Rensler came out.
Exactly. That's just what I was going to say. I think they put in a go-to foul, buddy.
Yeah. Stasiak will trigger it in around Holt. 44 seconds of play in the game. Rochester up by two. Bounce pass into Murphy. And Murphy is fouled by Lesenby. And that'll be
her fourth.
Yeah, Marley's fourth personal foul. And Carly will go back to the free throw line to shoot one of the bonus. With 42.8 to play in the game, Rochester by two at 36-34. And Rensler will come back into the game, and Taylor will sit down. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We have seen a really good basketball game here tonight. Neither team has led by more than six. Thomas is back and forth.
Yeah, 3 of 7 from the line tonight.
Burp hit the first one, and she breathes a deep sigh of relief. She'll have one more. As this lead is stretched to three, one more coming for the senior.
Tony gonna ice her.
Coach Stasiak will use a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
42.8 to play in the game. Rochester up 37-34 after the Rochester timeout. Carly Murphy will beat the line for one more free throw. And if there is ever a time that she needs to hit two, this one's it.
This would be it. And for the Lady Comets, Rensler is back in the game. So Rensler and Lazenby both with four fouls.
Murphy has one free throw. Trying to push this lead to four. The senior fires a second one. Good again. 38-34. Rochester in a full court press. Denton looks to get it in. Does so did Lesenby with 40. Lesenby holds, now drives to 38. Picks up a dribble, gives a head to Rand. Oh, Rand just about travels down to Rensler. Rensler with 30. Dribbles right side. Her pass is tipped away. Picked up by Rand. Her jumper in the lane is no good. Stasiak with the board at 28. Stasiak gives it to Holland. And before the pass, Keaton was fouled by Rand with 23.9 to play in the game. Rochester up by four. Rochester and Caston with two timeouts. Rochester has the possession arrow.
Rance picks up her second.
So Keaton Stasiak has one of the bonus. That was a ninth team foul. Rochester just 14 fouls. Keaton Stasiak first one, nothing but net. 39-34 Rochester. 23.9 to play in the game. Rochester by five. One more coming for Keaton Stasiak. Sophomore sets herself. Fires the second one. Good again. 40-34. Biggest lead of the night for Rochester. Lesenby with 20. Yeah, you're right. Lesenby backs away across the timeline against Malco with 17. Lesenby with 15. And then Coach Davis and Caston will use a timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new, faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email, listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
15 6.1 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 40-34. And after the Caston Comets timeout, they'll have the basketball in front of their own bench. They're down to one timeout. Rochester with two. The Lady Zebras still with a possession arrow. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. It's been a fantastic basketball game here at Caston. And I don't expect anything less in the next 15 seconds. Rand. Got to get it in. Finally does to Denton with 13. To Lesnaby with 12. Lesnaby behind the arc. Throws up a three. It's no good. And it goes out of bounds. And Rochester going to get it back with 7.8 to play in the game. And now Stasiak will use a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible, low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one Lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information or to see if you qualify for Lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2191.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
7.8 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 40-34. After the Rochester timeout, they'll have the basketball under the Caston basket. Needs to go the length of the floor. As Madison Taylor back in for fouling purposes. Becky Malco will look to trigger it in. Rochester up by 6 with 7.8 to play in the game. Malco, or make that Stasiak, looking to get it in. Bounce pass around defense to Murphy. Murphy dribbles away from the defense, and Holt picks up the foul. And Murph will go to the free throw line to shoot two. Rochester up by 6. Holt will pick up her third. So Curly Murphy will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras, who lead 40-34 with 6.3 to play in the game.
Murphy 5 of 9 from the line, 10 points.
First one for the senior goes. Denton and Renfrew back in. Taylor and Holt the sit. 41-34. One more coming for Rochester. Murph ready. Sets herself. Fires a second one. Nope. Long rebound dipped around. Rensler has it with three. Rensler crosses the timeline with two. Rensler's three at the buzzer. Nope. That'll do it. Rochester defeats the Caston Comets. 41-34. Post game thoughts after this on 92.1 WROI.